This time on Finnegan's Garage, I'm rewiring the fire chicken and doing some burnouts. Well, that was a pretty good one. That may bring the fire department. We should go.
Do you remember the Fire Chicken? That's the 1969 Pontiac Firebird that I bought basically out of a barn. Hadn't run in 10 years. And during episodes 67 and 68 of Roadkill, my friends and I brought this car back from the dead and attempted to do one lap of America in it. We failed miserably, as we often do on Roadkill, but we had a lot of fun. And now the car is back home. My brother actually owns it because, well, I blew up the Hemi in my 55 Chevy twice last summer and had to pay to fix it, so I sold the Firebird to him, kept it in the family, and he is ready to fix some of the problems this car has always had. Biggest problem this car has, though, is the wiring. It's a disaster. Things just shut off, turn on when you don't want them to. Things never worked. Headlights, taillights. He can't drive the car at night, basically. So with the help of Painless Performance products, we are now going to rewire the entire car from front to back with this new Pro Series wiring kit. Here we go. This should cover anything we need to do in this car. And holy cow, look at the instruction manual. That is a lot of pages. Wow. But the diagrams are good. The photos are good. I can actually read this. Okay. This just got less intimidating. Normally when you see a manual that thick, you think this is going to take forever, but it's full of diagrams. It's full of instructions. Oh, and more importantly, okay, this doesn't just tell you where to connect the wires. This tells you why you're connecting the wires. You can actually learn how a car is wired and how circuits work by reading this thing. Okay, for once in my life, I'm actually gonna read the instruction manual. We've got lots of GM style terminals, braided ground straps, parking light sockets, dimmer switch socket, headlight sockets. Wow. Look at that. Those are all GM style connectors. Which is why I have these. These are rollover crimpers. These are for properly crimping non-insulated terminals. So the cool thing about this harness is it's long on purpose so that you can route the wires and then cut and terminate every wire exactly where you need it. So no more rat's nest of wires bundled up under the dash. Okay, so this is a firewall bulkhead connector. This is really cool. So this is going to replace the factory one. This will go into the engine compartment. And then on the firewall side, it's going to plug right into the new fuse box, just like the factory did. And the really neat thing about this fuse box is these fuses, when they blow, they actually light up, which makes troubleshooting really easy. The other cool thing here is you have your turn signal flasher, your hazard flasher, your horn relay, all built in. This is great. Comes with shrink tubing. Okay. This isn't going to be that intimidating. Okay. So let me go find the section.
Coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça, ela, menina que vem e que passa, um doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é...
This is the greatest instruction manual ever written by mankind. This is amazing. I like to think that I understand how the electrical system in a car works. And for the most part, I do. But I started reading this, and right at the beginning it says, before you do anything, read the entire thing. And I thought, all right, why? Because almost every wire in that harness is labeled. It tells you what it goes to. So I thought, you could conceivably wire the car without ever picking this up. But had I done that, I wouldn't have learned how flashers work. And I don't mean, you know, dirtbags out on the street in a trench coat. I mean hazard flashers, turn signal flashers. I just learned how those operate, and I had no idea what they did. So, you know, your turn signal flasher, when you hit your turn signal, what happens, according to these guys at Painless Performance, is heat is built up in a resistance wire inside the flasher, right? So you hit the flasher, voltage goes into it, the wire gets hot. When the wire gets hot, it makes contact to the output side of the flasher and then sends the power out to, say, the turn signal. As soon as the turn signal gets the power, the resistance wire inside the flasher cools and disconnects from the output. And then the cycle starts all over again. And so it's just a wire getting hot in there is what's flashing things on and off. Which is why, if you upgrade your bulbs and your turn signals, your headlights, or anything like that, to LEDs, sometimes these stock flashers won't work, which is why Painless makes a no-load LED flasher option. I did not know that. I'm getting smarter. Haven't even started working on the car yet. Already, brain's getting bigger. This is amazing. Okay, I feel smart. Let's install it. Most of the wiring has been removed from the dash. What's left now is to remove the fuse box, which is on the inside of the firewall on the driver's side. But before you do that, you've got to unplug the engine compartment harness. And this is what it looks like. There's one bolt right there. It's a 3/8 head bolt. That secures it to the fuse box. So I unthreaded that, pulled this out. Now I can pull the fuse box out from the inside of the car. And that means the back half of the car, from firewall rearward, that's all unwired. So then all that's left is the two harnesses up front that go to the headlights and to the engine. I'm gonna unplug the taillight harness, and this is a good indicator of how bad the wiring in the car was. Yeah, that right there with all the electrical tape and the wires just twisted together, no butt connector, no crimp connection, no solder, like nothing. Nothing was holding that together. This one too. So it's a wonder I didn't get rear-ended during one lap of America by another car who was faster than me, which is pretty much every car at one lap of America. But it's a wonder they didn't run into me when the taillights probably weren't working on the racetrack or the street or the car wash. Yeah, that's crap. Somebody ran a ground wire from the body of the car to the taillight housing trying to fix a problem with the lights. Nothing on that side of the car. so we can move forward. Now to the fun part. I've never done this. I have no idea how difficult this is. I've done other painless harness installs before, but they were always like the race car kits, the bare bones stuff. I've never taken an old muscle car, ripped every scrap of wiring out, and tried to replace it with one of these. So this is going to be interesting, and my brother better appreciate this, because I'm cut. I'm dirty. I'm never dirty. Look at me. Look at me. All right. So that's the taillight harness, the main harness, the engine compartment harness, ground and power. I have no idea which one I should do first, so once again, I should probably read the instructions. Okay, I'll do it. Pre-installation guidelines. Before moving your new harness into your vehicle, it's a good exercise to lay the entire harness out on the ground. Look over the individual sections. All right. Wire index, page 124. Do not skip these pre-installation tips. See? Look at that. Everything you need to know is right on the wire. Courtesy light, passenger side door jam switch. So now that I know this goes to the passenger side door jam, I know I need to route this with the rest of the wires for the gauge cluster, because this will go up across the dash and over the passenger side of the car. Here we go. We now have our very first aftermarket connection for the Fire Chicken. All right, well, I've got the new harness and the fuse box sitting on top of the old harness and fuse box, and I'm doing that so that I can pre-route everything and cut things to length out here on the table from the comfort of my chair, not laying on my back under the dashboard of the Firebird. I'm gonna get this basically how it needs to be, put it in the car, and that's gonna save me a bunch of time later. This is as soon as I figure out how and where. Here we go.
porque estou tão sozinho. Porque tudo é tão triste.
Oh man, we're getting so close. Home stretch right now. This is the engine compartment harness. This has everything to fire the motor and control all the headlights, parking lights, turn signals, everything on the front end of the car. And really cool part of this is there are two outputs here for extra things you need powered by switched ignition. That's anything that needs power when the key is in the run and start position, which is awesome. And it just so happens, yes, I have something under there that needs power when the key is in the run and the start position. And that is my electric fan system. And there's an AccuSump under there that I would like to be working when the engine's running. So all I'm gonna do is take this terminal that was provided, attach my wire to it, shove it in the block, bolt the block to the firewall, and now I have wires that are carrying switched ignition power for my accessories, and I didn't have to drill a hole in the firewall, I didn't have to go punch a hole through a grommet, none of that stuff. Yay me. Oh, there's those pliers. Hold on. We need to talk about something while we're here. So, Painless recommends using roll-style crimping pliers when you make these connections. And these are really difficult to use. It's actually beyond me to use these competently. Like, you should just be able to put the terminal in there and crimp it, and it should take those two tangs right there and fold them over and dig them in to the insulation of the wire, right? They shouldn't overlap, they shouldn't just come to a peak, they should just roll over and dig in, and that's what keeps the wire from pulling out. That's how it's supposed to function. Just put it in there and crimp it. I am incapable of making that happen with these pliers. And it's remarkable. Like, crimp it, terminal gets stuck, I break the terminal, or they roll over and overlap, or they don't roll over at all. Like, I'm having serious issues with these. So I've abandoned using them, even though I know that's the correct tool to be using. And instead, I am pre-bending the tangs with a pair of pliers like that. And then I'm using my handy dandy Klein crimping tool, which also has a roll crimp built into it. And this, although not the correct size for this terminal, will get me halfway there. And then I'll finish the job with the part you actually used to cut wire. Again, not the correct way to do this, but does work in pinch. And clearly right now I'm pinched because I can't seem to work the traditional roll crimp tool. However you do this, just give it the old tug test at the end and make sure the wire doesn't rip out, because that's going to burn you later when you go wire your whole car and you put two connections together and it either forces the wire out or forces the pin out or whatever. Suddenly you've just rewired your whole car and something doesn't work correctly just because you didn't have a good tight connection. That's better. So there's two sets of tangs here, and with the right tool, what was happening is the tangs would roll up and hit each other, and instead of rolling over and digging in to the insulation like they're supposed to. So this is basically what it should look like. These should not overlap. These should not do anything but dig into the insulation of the wire here and then dig into the strands of the wire there. And lots of these on the market, they usually work. I just can't seem to do it today. So Wrong tool for the job, but working. Here's what I've learned so far. This is not a drop in the car harness. You have to modify it, which I'm the kind of guy that actually likes to do that sort of thing, because I laid the new Pro Series harness and fuse box on top of the old one, followed the original routing locations for all the wires and all the sockets, and was able to cut this much out of it. So now I can go back in here and tape the harness just like the factory did, include this piece, which goes above the gauge cluster, and it will look almost like it did from the factory, and it'll be the right length. And when I go into the car right now, everything will just plug in and fall into place. It'll be that easy. After that, all I've got to do is run the rear section of the harness to the back of the car, the bulkhead connector to the engine, wire those points, and then address one monster issue that I discovered while working on this, and that's the fact that most of the ground network for the dash panel was busted. And that's probably what caused half the problems in this car. Beyond the fact that mice had eaten some of the wires and somebody butchered the taillight wiring, there was no ground going from the wiper switch to the headlight switch. You'll see that in a second. I'll show you. Harness is ready to go in the car, but before we do that, we're going to address one more problem, and this is probably the culprit for most of the electrical gremlins in the Fire Chicken. And that is a piss-poor stereo installation. Somebody hacked out the area behind the dash panel for the stereo, and when they did that, they hacked through the metal bezel behind it, and that metal bezel connects the HVAC controls to the cigarette lighter, to the gauge cluster. That's a grounding path for all these things. That is now broken in half right there. And then, if you come over here, you know, I talked about the fact that you couldn't drive the car at night, the headlights wouldn't work, everything's weird. Well, the ground bezel here for the headlight switch and the wiper switch goes nowhere. There's supposed to be a bracket that goes from here to the dash, the frame of it. There's nothing there. So nothing's grounding these switches. Nothing's grounding the HVAC. Nothing's grounding the cigarette lighter. I mean, it's a wonder anything worked in this car. So beyond the fact that mice had chewed through some of the wires in the factory harness, somebody butchered the taillight wiring in the back, we had this happening. So we're gonna fix this, put in our new Pro Series harness. By the time we're done, this car should work perfectly. Okay, let's install it. Yeah, buddy. After two full days of wrenching, we are almost done. Fusible link is now in between the alternator and the battery to protect that charge wire, and we are ready to put the dash back together. And then see if the lights work and if we can do a burnout while having headlights. That's kind of the key to this whole thing. Can we drive at night while allegedly making smoke on public roads? Don't know. Let's find out. Well, it doesn't work. Might as well take it apart. Why am I getting road killed? This sucks. What did I do to deserve this? I donate to charity. I'm nice to children. I help old people. Yeah, so I barbecued the tires on my brother's car. I'm sure he would have done that himself. I was just helping in the process. Oh my god. This is really dumb. Actually, I think I can get the switch out without taking the dash back apart. That won't be so bad. Except unplugging it's gonna be difficult. No, I was wrong. Can't get a socket in there to do that. Okay, get to start over again. Yeah, see? That's what it's supposed to do. I have no idea if this works. I could take the dash apart, put this back in there, put the dash all the way back together, then try to make this work. There's no guarantees it does. Damn it. And actually, that should just go all the way together without me even pushing the switch. Give an update. You ready? Moment of truth. I've resorted to drinking. Come on. Yeah. Oh, that's so strange. I had that switch in and out twice, and I could get it to work, and then it wouldn't work, and I could get it to work, and then it wouldn't work, and it didn't matter if it was plugged in, unplugged, bolted in, bolted out. It just didn't want to be consistent. Now all of a sudden it just decides, yeah, no problem, Mike, let's work. And I really think it was because I started drinking. I really think that's what fixed this whole thing. Thank you, Samuel Adams. Thank you. All right, I'm going to bolt the steering column in. Headlights to the taillights, every inch of wiring in this car has been replaced. There are no more butt connectors holding things together. There are no random splices. No mice have fed on this harness. In fact, everything plugs in all the way back here to the taillights. And now, if my brother wanted to, with taillights and headlights, he could do burnouts in the dark.